The village of Lisbon sees growth as new businesses set up shop and officials and building owners make an effort to revitalize. That story on today's Daily Buzz.
Today's Business Journal Daily Buzz is brought to you by 717 Credit Union.
The village of Lisbon has seen an influx of new businesses this year as officials and business owners work to enhance the historic downtown, making it a more walkable business district.
That's one of our focuses right now, is trying to get it back to that place where we believe it once was.
Susan Shank is president of the Lisbon Area Chamber of Commerce. She says there have been about 9 new businesses that have opened or are planning to open this year. One of them, opening up in February, is Tales of the Town Pet Grooming Salon, owned by Carla Sadler.
When I was looking for a good place to open, we looked at the demographics, where there was groomers, where there was a need for groomers.
But beyond that, Sadler said she wanted to be a part of a small town atmosphere.
So we're very excited to be in a town that is growing, and we feel that as long as they're growing, there's room for us to grow.
New businesses coming soon to the village include a brewery, a coffee shop, a nonprofit, and a graphic design company.
We're trying to round off the types of businesses that we are getting in here. We always need places to eat. There's need for restaurants. There's a need for small novelty shops. There's a need for service.
More new businesses will be coming to the former Morgan Drugstore building, currently being renovated. Rennie Lewis is the owner and also the owner of the Courthouse Inn and Restaurant. The new brightly painted structure, dubbed the Phoenix, will soon house an art gallery, an apothecary, a law office, an art studio, 5 loft apartments, and a jewel healing room complete with a gemstone waterfall.
So it's quite a large building and it's a huge endeavor, and it's going to be finished by the end of fall.
Lewis says she hopes her revitalization efforts will spur others to do the same for the village.
This is the oldest building. The Courthouse Inn and Restaurant is the oldest standing building that's not a log structure in the entire state. There's so much history in this town, and it was just being neglected. So I just thought, you know, if I start, other people will start. And I think it's happening. I think there's a renaissance that's happening.
But while many buildings are seeing improvements, others have laid vacant. Mayor Roger Gallo says last year the village enacted a vacant building ordinance requiring owners to market their properties and bring them up to code.
Basically trying to encourage people either to rent their property or to sell it. We have some folks that are interested in those properties, and we've got folks putting millions of dollars into projects, and then we got an adjacent property that won't even wash their windows.
Another step towards revitalization is through the Chamber's Lisbon Landmark Foundation, a 501c3 organization acquiring properties to rehabilitate them for sale. Executive Director of the Chamber, Marilyn McCullough, says the first building in the works is the Nace Pharmacy building on Market Street.
They're applying now for grants, and they're wanting to make the structure sound, and that way then they'll resell them, but then they would take those proceeds and buy another building.
Recently, the village invested in underground utilities and period light poles for the downtown. Through a $5,000 grant from the National Association of Realtors, a new park will be created close to the Greenway Trailhead.
We get 250,000 people a year going across the bike trail.
To draw in more visitors, the village holds events for the community every month. The most recent, held in September, is their annual Johnny Appleseed Festival, a 2-day event which McCullough says brings in 6,000 to 7,000 people a day.
It's a great time of fellowship and marketing our town.
And on October 26th, Lisbon will host a brand new event for Halloween, Zombies Take Lisbon.
There won't be a fee, but they're to bring a can of food, and as their admission, and of course dress however they want. Then the food will be donated to, we have a couple food pantries in town, and so the food will be taken to them.
Lisbon has been amazing to us.
Lisbon, Ohio is the epicenter of greatness, you know.
It's a good place to live and work, and I think we're on the upswing.
You can read more in George Nelson's story in the October issue of the Business Journal, out now. Click subscribe under the Contact Us tab to get your copy today. 717 Credit Union, savings power to give your business an extra boost. Business savings, certificates, and business money market. 717 Credit Union, make your money work as hard as you do.